A very important application of ratio and proportion is what is this partnership. Today in our session, we are just going to see the basics of partnership. Basically, what is partnership? Say there are some two or three friends, they are just going to do some business. To start a business, we definitely need some investment, some capital. Say each of these friends are just going to put their share and start the business. And let us just say that that business is also growing well. And after some particular time, at the end of the period, what happens is they'll be getting some gain, and this gain all of them are going to share. How this gain should be shared between them and how this concepts is what all about this partnership. Let us just see different cases of what happens in this partnership problem. Let us say that there are three people, A, B, C. They're going to start a business by investing. A is going to invest A rupees. And B is going to invest B rupees as B share, and C going to invest C rupees. So this A, B, C are the rupees they are all going to invest. So we will take them as the investments, their respective investments. Now they are going to invest, and let us assume that they are all going to invest at the start of the business itself. That is, what we can here understand is, if they are going to invest at the starting of the business, then all of their investments will be staying in the business for the same period of time. This point we have to understand. Provided if they are not taking anything, any money from the business or adding any money in the business, if they keep it constant, then all of their money will be, that is their investments are going to be staying for the same time period in the business. Then after some period of time, let us say that there is a profit coming. So some gain they are going to get, some profit. Now this profit, all of the three people are going to share. Now, each of them will get how much? This is the point, or this is the task we have to do here. So here, what we can try to find is, first of all, let us try to find in what ratio they are going to share their profit. Then that itself will easily give us how much share each of them are going to get. Okay. So this logic is quite very easy, because we'll have to see how much money they are all investing. So they are all investing A, B and C respectively. So here the thing is, their money can, whichever can be greater or the other one can be lesser, that doesn't matter at all. But here, in what ratio they are all investing, in the same ratio is what their money should also be shared, that is their gain should also be shared. Okay, so the gain should be shared in the ratio, the same ratio as their investment. So they will be sharing that profit in the ratio A is to B is to C. Now we'll go like, all their money which they have invested are going to stay in the business for different time periods. That is, for instance, if A's money is going to stay for some P months in the business, and B's money for some Q months in the business, and C for R months. That is, this P, Q, R, these are going to be the number of months for which their money is going to stay in the business. Okay, all of them are in months. It can be years or weeks or days, whatever, but it is important that all the things should be in the same units. That is very much important. So this is going to be the time period for which their money are going to stay in the business. Then now, then what way or in what ratio they will be splitting, they will be sharing the given profit. This is what we have to now find. So for this, what we have to do is, our step is, it's again very easy. Here we'll have to take the investment, how much they have invested, and take the time period for which their money is there in the business. We will have to multiply the two components. Okay, so now the ratio will be simply nothing but, for A it will be like A into P is to, next B's component will be B into Q, and into, for C it will be C into R. So now this AP is to BQ is to CR will be the ratio in which now they will be sharing the given profit. If we see partnership problems, that we'll be having many situations like, you'll be having money and we'll be removing some money from the investment, and we'll be adding some extra money to the investment, or some will be leaving the partnership, some other will be joining, or some will be there as a working partner, like this. But for all these, what we are just seeing is going to be the basic concept. We'll separately see this partnership problem in our other channel, VAAGAI Math for You. And for more such maths concepts like this, kindly subscribe my channel, VAAGAI Math Coaching, and we'll catch up in the next session with some other new concept. See you there. Thank you so much.